Get up and move. What do you you to open to the book of Jeremiah. Jeremiah, the 17th chapter. I've discovered some great things in here. We're going to talk about bushes and trees. Did you know we have bushes in the Bible and how they're related, and trees in the Bible and how they're related? Jeremiah, you got a Scofield, it's on 7-9. 7-9, if you haven't done it for it. Are you ready? All right, let's go. The fifth verse of the 17th chapter. Thus saith the Lord, cursed be the man that trusteth in man, and maketh flesh his arm, and whose heart departeth from the Lord. For he shall be like the heath in the desert, and shall not see when good things come, but shall inhabit the parched land in the wilderness, in a salt land, and inhabited, not inhabited. Blessed is the man that trusteth in the Lord, and whose hope is in the Lord, for he shall be as a tree planted by the waters, and that spreadeth out his root by the river, and shall not see when heat cometh. But her leaf shall be green, and shall not be careful in the year of drought, neither shall cease from yielding fruit. The heart is deceitful above all things, and desperately wicked. Who can know it? I, the Lord, search the heart and try the reins, even to give every man according to his ways and according to the fruit of his, what's that word?
Doing.
Of his doing. Now, we're going to show you in a minute about the bush and about the tree, and about God and man and planting and water and roots and fruit. Now, in the fifth verse, we're going to go word by word and verse by verse this morning to try to open up the word that you'll have a greater understanding of. I want you to notice who's speaking. Not me, not the author of this book, not Jeremiah, not any of the prophets. But the one doing the speaking is God. First thing, God is speaking. This is a word from him. Thus saith the Lord, cursed be the man that trusteth in man. Now I want you to look down in the seventh verse. Blessed is the man that trusteth in the Lord. So we're having left hand, right hand. There is a curse to the man that trusteth in man. And then there is a blessing to those that trust in the Lord. Thus saith the Lord, cursed is the man that trusteth in man. Now we're living at a time that we're getting ready to elect a president. And every politician that I've ever met in my lifetimes, there are a lot. Y'all said?
Amen.
They tell us what we want to hear in order for them to get in office. Now, our whole perspective is life is what we hear, what we read, what we're taught in school. That's our whole perspective. It never did make any sense to me when we talked about Darwin's theory of evolution. Now, the word theory should knock it in the head to start with.
Right.
Theory means that is his opinion, no proof, no exactness. And he says that this is his theory, but one thing is missing. Well, there's not anything missing with God. He said in the beginning, God created heavens and earth and everything therein. He made man from the dust of the earth. So God gives us a complete picture. Darwin's theory is a theory, is all that it is. One thing I've never understood about it, if we evolved from monkeys, why aren't we viewing some part of evolution now? There ought to be a monkey somewhere that's half and half.
Amen.
Make any sense to you? Now, when we talk about the Big Bang Theory, it's like me telling you that they gathered some metal and some plastic and some rubber, and then there was a big explosion and it became a car. That tells me if you see a car, you see a house, you see a tree, you see a stream, there had to be a designer, a creator of it all. So our knowledge comes from man. But he said, cursed, cursed. If all we're listening to and our values and our opinions and our theories are drawn from what man said, it is a curse unto us. So cursed be the man that trusteth in man and maketh flesh his arm. Now when it says maketh flesh his arm, that means where your strength is. That's why our life is a roller coaster. We're happy when we get a job, and then we curse the job. We're happy when we get a raise, but it's not enough raise. We're happy when we get a new home, but then that home becomes worn, and we got to work and repair on it, and we don't like it anymore. Our cars are wonderful when we buy them, and it's still got that new smell in it, but you let it rain in it and it stinks and we don't like it anymore and we want another. So cursed is every man that trusts in man and he draws his strength from man. That's why that we're not strong. That's why we live in disillusion. That's why that our lives are in such a mess today. Amen. Now, if you don't like what's happening today, you just wait. It'll change tomorrow. Now, all of our officials that are trying to get elected, I've never heard in my life them call them so many names. I would probably want to wrestle if people talk to me like they're talking to each other. The filth that's coming out of their mouth. Our country was founded on In God We Trust. But now it's founded on we are the greatest nation in the world. We're not. We have the strongest army in the world. We don't. We're trying to bring to pass our greatness by saying what we are. The third thing in that, it talks about trusting in man, trusting in your own strength, and whose heart departeth from the Lord. So we're in a time that people have departed from God.
Amen.
God no longer is in their vision. When the America was in World War I, the houses of God were filled and the altars were filled with mothers and daddies praying for their sons. World War II, the same thing. But now after that even though we've been in a constant war, the houses of God are getting empty. Mamas and daddies have quit praying. The communities have quit praying. We have departed. We have departed. So he says there is a curse. You ever feel like you're the only one in the world going through what you're going through?
Yeah.
Boy, y'all are quite as much higher. Nobody understands me. My husband don't listen to me. My wife don't understand me. My teachers don't understand me. The only one I can talk to is this, always like this part. Women work. Men work. Now the wife can't talk to the husband, but they can talk to somebody on the job. Oh, look out, you're treading on thin ice.
Yeah.
All we're doing is just talking. Starts out that way. Men, my wife won't listen, but I found somebody at work that'll listen. And all we're doing is just talking. That's all Eve did to the serpent. Are you with me?
Yes.
We just talking.
Yep.
But talking led to deception, and deception led to sin. So there's a perpetual motion in things that's going. So if we departed from God, curse it. There is a curse on America. There is a curse on our homes. There there is a curse on us as individuals because we have departed from the true living God and we're listening to what man says that we ought to do and we're turning to our own strength is what the world tells us we need to have in order to be strong. Is that all right? I want you to look at the sixth verse. I want you to underline this. For he shall be like. It didn't say that he would be. So he's going to give us a comparison. The man that departs from God, trust in man, trust in the strength of his flesh, he said he would be like. So here's a comparison coming. He would be like what? What's a he? It said that he would be like a heath in the desert. The word heath means a bush. That's the definition. He'd be like a bush in the desert. Now what grows in the desert? Why can't things grow in the desert? Strife. Now how much in this verse, it never says that this bush has a root system. But it talks about the tree having a root system. What does a bush depend on? It depends on the rain. What does a tree depend on? It depends upon what's in the ground and it draws from the ground. So the bush, is that you? You're trying to let the world rain on you to give you what you think you need. For he shall be like a bush in the desert. Second thing. And he shall not see when good cometh. You see anything good in life? Well, I'm not even going to vote. I've watched our candidates. People don't like the one that the people chose. I'm not going to vote for that heathen. They're all just alike. Let me say, if you don't vote, you are voting.
Amen.
If you don't vote, you're casting your ballot. You say, well, I don't like him and I don't like her. You better pick you out one. Have I offended you? Almost. Almost. Can't see anything good. Now, the Bible said there is none good save God. God's the only one that's good. So when someone witnesses to you about Christ, you can't see any good. What good is that going to do me? I need money. I need a place to live. I need my family together. I need something in life that I can't find. Well, the more you get, the more you want, and the more you want, the more you get, and the more unhappy that you are. Amen. Can't see any good. I can't see any good in Donald Trump. Can't see any good in Hillary Clinton. Can't see any good in Bernie Sanders. I can't see any good in any of them. Well, may not be, but we don't have much of a choice, do we? So just pull up your big boy britches, go punch something, and go on down the road. So people, he says, because you're cursed, because you've trusted in man, because that's what you've drawn your strength from, you have departed from God, and you have become like a bush that's in the desert. You have no water. All you've got is sand. Now, if you get ready to pull a bush up, how much effort does it take if it's in the sand? I mean, that's a one-handed job, isn't it? That tells us no depth, no root, no strength, no power, nothing at all in your life. And it's simply because you have a curse on you because your decisions that the curse has come. Why? We've departed from God. Let me explain a little deeper. Adam created, or God created Adam and Eve, put them in the garden. They had fellowship with God. Now man was not only created physically, fleshly, he was created spiritually. And he had fellowship with God. God walked with him, but as soon as they sinned, they were expelled from the garden, and that fellowship, that spiritual part of them with God, diminished. No fellowship. Now, the reason that we're having problems in our lives is because there's something missing in our lives. And what's missing in our lives is a spiritual part. And God created man to have fellowship with him. And so until you get things right with God, until you get saved, until you get in fellowship with God, there is a departure from God. You've been cursed. You are as a bush. Sixth verse, and he shall be like the heart in the desert, and shall not see any good, and shall inhabit the parched land. Now the inhabitants, or what you're going to inhabit, is the place that you live. The place that you live. Have you ever tried to get shade under a bush? I mean, anywhere you turn, the sun is going to shine on you. So instead of a person that is departed, is cursed, because his strength lies upon man and the knowledge of men, they, in their own ways, they can't see anything good. They can't see any way out of the situation that they're in. And they inhabited the parched land. We watched this past few years that California is in a drought. And no matter how many seed they sow, no matter how many times they till their land, no matter how many times they plant their crops, it won't grow. It has no water. The seed that we sow, the plants that we put in the ground, they don't have a deep root system, so they're depending on what falls. That's rain. So if you don't get any rain, you're living in a parched land. So now you're starting to understand and see why your lives are in the shape they're in. A parched land means nothing. And it says parched land in the wilderness, not only in the wilderness, that's an uninhabited land, a land where nobody lives, a salt land. Now what are you going to do if you decide to grow a crop and it's like the salt flats? You're in a mess! You're trying to be productive. You're trying to be happy. You're trying to find something that's going to give you something to smile about. But man, you're living in the desert and you ain't nothing but a bush. You have no depth because you have no root. And you have no strength because you're not getting any rain. Now, a bush can produce a fruit. But man, that fruit ain't good for nothing. Little old swiveled up, dried up, pruny looking thing. We got a prune or two in here. Pucker! Oh man, we're going to have to do something. I don't know what, we're going to have to do something. A land not inhabited. Nobody wants to live there. Nobody wants to be around you. Yeah, you understand why people don't come see you. You're pruning. You're a bush. You have nothing to offer. You know what? As soon as somebody comes to see you, you tell them where you hurt, what operation you had, what you're going through, how people are treating you. Man, I don't want to come see you. I don't want to be around you. How do you stand you? That's why you're in a bad state of depression. It's because you're a bush. Now, we're going to get off that. Tag, right? You look at the person sitting next to you and look at them right in the eye and tell them, you're a bush. Come on, some of you didn't do it. Look at them, tell them, you're a bush. Depending on somebody to pour water on you so that you can get some relief. You're living in the desert. Nobody wants to live close to you because nothing grows in the desert but a pruned up, dried up bush. Isn't that good stuff? That is good stuff. But I'm glad he didn't quit there. He came to the 7th verse. In the 5th verse, he said, cursed. In the 7th verse, he said, blessed. Now, I like that word. Boy, do I like to be blessed. Any good when your Lord comes around and says, I'm going to give you a bonus? That's blessed. Isn't it wonderful when you walk through the door and your wife runs up and she puts a toilet plunger kiss on you? What I'm talking about, dude. When you come to the doctor, now what? Now what do you want me to do? Come on, ladies, help.
Amen.
What do you want me to do? You walk in.
Look, well, they don't look
be a tree and not a bush. You didn't know all that's in there, did you? It's there. So I don't want to be a bush. Blessed is the man that trusteth in the Lord. Now, I want you to underline the word trusteth. It has some depth to it. It's mentioned 152 times in the Old Testament. And the word trust, you know what it means? It's translated in the Hebrew. It is faith and belief. Faith and belief. By grace are you saved through faith. It's the gift of God, not a works lest any man should boast. Trust, faith, and belief. So it says, a man that trusteth in man is cursed. A man that trusteth in God is going to be blessed. In the Lord. So God's going to do the blessing. Man can't bless you. Man can't give you what you need. He cannot give you the response to tell you what's wrong inside you. But God can. Blessed is a man that trusteth in the Lord and whose hope is in the Lord. Well, I just hope tomorrow be better than today. I just hope. I said this. You got some good hope for the seat? I believe we're going to have 300 here next Sunday. And all of you said ever since I've been here.
Amen.
No, you didn't. You didn't say it. What's wrong with him? Now, here's the problem. It's not what's wrong with me. It's what's wrong with you.
Amen.
If you believe it, you do it. Do I need to say that again? If you believe it, you'll do it. Now, how can we have that number here? How can we get those? It only comes because you believe it and you're willing to go out and make it happen. You say, well, I got to pray about it. You don't have to pray about that. God said he wasn't willing that any should come to walk. Isn't that wonderful? God don't want anybody to go to hell. So he's put us here as the messengers to divert people from going to hell in order to get them into the presence of God. Eighth verse. For he shall be. Now you remember when it talked about the bush, it said he would be like. He would be like. Here it said he would be. He would be. So that tells us that God is going to make something out of us. God's not going to let us do and live the way we've been living because it didn't work. Now, we shall be because God is going to cause it to happen. As a tree planted by the water. Now, underline that word planted. That means that somebody took care in order to dig a hole, in order to reach way down where the water was and put the tree. It talked about the bush, it just sprang up. Sprang up in sand in the desert, in the parched land, depended on the rain. But it says, blessed is the man. Blessed is the man that trusts in the Lord. Because he is like a tree that's planted by the waters. Tree that's planted by the waters. Now, when it's planted by the waters, it just don't stay planted. What happens to it? It said it spreads. It spreads. What does it spread to? It spreads its root system. A bush don't have a root system. But a tree has a root system. What does a root system do? The root system feeds it. The root system waters it. And the root system secures it. And is it all right? Now, what security do you have if you're a bush? What strength do you have if you're a bush? So I don't want to be a bush. Now, this is better stuff. It's planted by the river. Now, a river is something that does not run dry. I mean, it's perpetually flowing. It might get a little low, but if it gets low, the root system goes a little bit deeper. It seeks out food and water. I'm glad that I've got a foundation, and I'm glad that I've got a root system that gives me strength and that feeds me, which comes by the Word of God through the power of the Holy Spirit of God. I want to get done with this where you can go home. But I'm interested in this. This is telling me something about me. I mean, this is a doctor that put me on the table, took my temperature, checked my heart, and hit me on the knee to see if my reflexes are any good. He is giving me a physical. And I don't like to flunk anything. Doctor, listen to my heart. I say, how does it sound, Doc? Pump my arm up, get my blood pressure. I look up, I said, how is it? Oh, it's good. You got any problems? No, don't have a problem. And some of you not like that. And then the doctor said, this doctor always said, all the doctors said, is there anything you want me to give you? And our reply is, yes! I need some help, Doc! Not going to touch it. Ooh, all you get is a temporary fix.
That's right.
And you still got the same problem. Notice what this tree does. It's planted, got a root system, planted by the river. It feeds and grows and has depth, and shall not see when the heat cometh. Now, it makes no difference to that tree if it gets to be 120 degrees, because it's got plenty of food and it's got plenty of water. As long as you've got food and you've got water, you're secure. That's the essence and the sustainer of life. Plenty of it. Now that bush, depending on the rain, what nature gives it, if it don't rain, it just gonna wither up. It'll sit there and just dry up. And if it was producing any fruit, the fruit will dry up and it'll fall off. Man, I didn't know all that was there. I want you to underline that. And, it goes on to say, but her leaves shall be green. No matter how hot the sun gets, no matter what the situation of nature gets, bless God, got plenty of water, got plenty of food, got plenty of depth, and the leaves on it still going to be green. You know what happens to a dead leaf? It falls on, it's about to fall off. Not producing anything. And shall be careful. I want you to underline the word careful. Word careful means fearful. This tree is not fearful. Now, when is it not fearful? In the year of drought. It makes no difference what comes. Makes no difference what comes your way. You don't have to fear it, because your strength is in God. You are a tree. You're not a bush. You are a tree that's planted by the waters. In the year of the drought, nothing shall cease for yielding fruit. God said, even though the world is falling apart around you, you're still going to keep producing fruit. Isn't that good? It makes no difference. If you get laid off from your job, you're still eating. If you get sick and then you're in the bed, somebody's taking care of you. So why fear? But you trust in God, let Him be in your heart. Ninth verse, the heart is deceitful. Above all things, the heart's deceitful. And desperately wicked. Who can know it? Underline the word heart. Here it's translated meaning mind. Mind. After Adam and Eve sinned, put out of the Garden of Eden, was a dispensation of conscience. And the Bible says that man's conscience was evil, and it got more evil, and all the thoughts was just evil thoughts. Come back with me again. Before you got saved, oh, I just think good thoughts. I've never thought an evil thought in my life. I just think good thoughts. You're alive, you're alive, you're alive. He says, the mind is deceitful above all things and desperately wicked. Desperately wicked. Then look at what it says. Somebody tell me. Who can know it? That's why that you say, I don't even know why I'm here. I don't even know why I married that thing. I don't know why I even took that job. Well, yesterday you thought you knew, but today you don't know. It's because of your mind. You're dependent on the strength of man and of flesh and what lies within you. And now we're finding out that it is desperately wicked, and who can know it? You can't see my mind. If you did, it'd drive you crazy. I went to bed last night, and all night long, I said, no doubt about it, going to sing, going to shout it, and I said, quit doing that. Think of bush, 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 bush. No doubt about it, going to sing, going to shout it, tree, 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 tree. No doubt about it. And I got up this morning, I said, I am wore out. I am absolutely wore out. Don't want to be a bush. I want to be a tree. Now I know I can't trust my mind. I know I cannot be led by my mind. I know I cannot be led by what people have told me. I know that. So here's the answer. 10th verse. I, the Lord. He's speaking. I, the Lord. What's he going to do? Search the heart. That means he's going to do a heart cath on you. You mean he's going to put dye in me? Yes. Why? He's going to see what's wrong with you. And got a blockage? Well, the left side of my heart had 98% blockage. Right side had 95%. All the front of it was just a mess. Well, what are they going to do? They're going to take it out. I told them when I had my heart attack, just get a Roto-Rooter and use on it. Clean that thing out. So God said, the heart you can't trust, the mind you can't trust, I'm going to look inside of it, and I'm going to see what's inside of it. Then he said, I want to try the heart. He said he's going to search it, but then he's going to go further than searching it. He's going to try it. Y'all wake up if you can. Almost done. Don't want to miss it. Now, what's the reins of it? What's the reins of the heart? Say loud.
What drives it?
Somebody else?
God.
What you got on your car that when you sit down in the driver's seat and you reach up and grab?
Steers it.
What drives it?
Steering wheel.
What motivates?
Motion.
Gonna spend it. And then you want more? Let me tell you what God is. God has an unending supply. The more you want of Him, the more He gives of Himself to you.
Amen.
And the more of God you get in the life, then your mind begins to get straightened out. Amen. Then you begin to see a direction. Then you begin to see that there's something that has been missing and now you've found it. And you didn't have to wait and go to Kmart to the blue light special.
Yeah.
He said He searches the heart, the reins of the heart, even to give every man, according to his ways. God said, all right, I've looked in your heart. I see now what's driving your heart, what's wrong with your heart. And I'm going to give to you according to your ways. And according to the fruit of your doing. Now, if you're unjust and if you're sinful, God said it's there and I'm going to give you. I'm going to judge you and I'm going to give you. Cursed is the bush. No root system, no water, no depth, no strength. I'm going to give you according to your doing. Now you see what a mess we're in. Every one of us. Every one of us is in a mess. Because we have a choice to be blessed or to be cursed. Be blessed or be cursed. You remember the woman at the well? Last thing. Woman at the well. Jesus met her. Jesus said, I must needs go through Samaria. And he needed to go there because there's somebody there that needed something. So the woman came to the well and she drawed water. Jesus said, give me the drink. She said, you mean you come to the well and you don't have a bucket, you don't have a rope, you don't have anything to get water? How do you expect to get water? That's man leaning to his own understanding. But Jesus said, well, the water I've got, if you drink of it, you'll never thirst again. And the woman said, give me this water, because if you give me this water, I won't have to be walking back and forth and carrying water. Didn't have a clue of what the Lord was talking about. But she got clued in. He said, go get your husband. Said, I don't have one. Jesus said, you've been married 5 times and you're jacking up, man. She went to the city and said, hey, I found a man that's got living water because he told me all things. So when God opens us up and looks in our hearts, he knows exactly all things about us. And this is the good thing about it. He loves us in spite of it. Stand together.